Hello, my name is Leopoldo Armesto, and in this presentation, we're going to introduce the main concepts on how to develop apps with App Inventor. So this is the outline of the presentation, and we're going to first talk about App Inventor, and then talk about the designer and the block views, and how to work with screens and how screens works. And then I'm going to focus on the components of App Inventor, particularly user interface components, layout components, sensor components and connectivity components, which are the ones, the main ones that we are going to use along this kind of course. So App Inventor, it has been designed and it's maintained by the MIT Center for Mobile Learning, and it runs a Google App engine that is used to allow everyone to develop and deploy apps running in Android and lately in iOS as well. It requires a Google account in order to log in. So once logged, you have, as a user, you have a project list that you can even publish to a gallery. And it's used by many educational centers and ICT courses around the world, and also for enthusiastic people, of course, around the world. And it's recommended to be used from 10 and above. And it's used by, even, of course, by adults. It's using a block programming tool anyway, and that's why we can use it for kids as well. And it contains tools for importing and exporting projects, and also to connect with physical or devices or emulators, and to build, in the end, your project and compile it into an APK file or to an APP bundle. And also another feature of App Inventor is that it can use extensions in order to extend some of the features of, or the basic features that App Inventor provides. So you can extend them by using extensions. So App Inventor has two views, the designer and the block view. In the designer view is where we define the aspect of our app in design time. That means when we are developing the app. And it contains a palette in which we have all the components that can be used in the app and can be drag and drop. And also contains or displays the screen that you want to work, and all the list of components that are being used in this screen, and also their hierarchical relation between them, their parents and childs. And also, of course, we can, once you have one specific component selected, you can, on, let's say, this at design time, you can set some of the properties of the component, like the color, the size, things like that. And of course, we can also upload media files like images, videos, and audios in order to be used in our project. And then we have the block view. This is where we introduce the actual code for our app, or the logic for our app. And basically what we put here in the block view, it's of course part of our development, it's the actual code that will be executed at runtime. And we can distinguish between different kinds of blocks within the block view. We have built-in blocks, which are generic blocks in order to program all the logic of any program. We have blocks specific for every kind of component. So when you select a component, then you will have block instructions that are specialized for this kind of component. And also we have some blocks that are any component. Like, let's say that any type of, let's say any button can be managed using one single instruction, so that it's a way to say, okay, I don't want to do something specifically for this button, but for in general for any button, things like that. So in our app, we're going to create the screens, and each screen has a list of its own components, or keeps a list of its own components. And we can, move from one screen to another one by open from one screen, we can open a second screen. And that will be put on top of the stack navigator. So the new screen that will be displayed will be the one that has been opened. And when we close the screen, then we will see that one will pop out from the navigator stack, and then we will see the one that was below. And of course, we can pass some data between screens. And also, screens are the ones that are in charge of, let's say, asking permissions for to the user, like, let's say, activate localization services or connectivity permissions, things like that. And that has to be allowed by the user. So we have been talking about components, okay? But what are components? There are different kinds of components in App Inventor. We have visible components and non-visible components. Visible components are the ones that we use in our user interface and are part or they belong to our screen, and we where we want to display some data and or let the user interact with it. And of course, that they can be hidden or shown, but they belong, they are visible components in the end. And they have to be organized in a specific layout, and for that we use layout components. And non-visible components are part of our screen, but they are, let's say, used in our code, but but they are not shown in the screen, but they are used in order to get data, let's say, from sensors, like or reading a temperature or getting the actual clock time or querying some data. All these kind of things are non-visible components. And each component in the end has properties and also has some events and some methods. Properties define how the component behaves, and they can be set at design time, but also in the block view by coding and setting specific values for each of the properties of the components, or we can get a specific value of a component, while events are, let's say, pieces of code that are executed on demand because an external signal occurs that, let's say, triggers that event, like a click of a button, and they are executed in the block view, of course. And also some components, they have methods. Methods are functions that they do something, like in this example here, you see a Bluetooth client disconnects. It's a routine that we want to do something complex, and it's behind the user, and some methods might return a value, others they don't. Well, and specifically, within all the components the App Inventor has, we want to highlight user interface components. We have distinguished between components that interact with the user, like buttons, images, checkboxes, sliders. So the user interacts with this kind of components. Also, we have components like pickers, in which we want to select a date or a time or an element on a list. These are list pickers in this case. And that pop-ups, once we click on them, pop-ups a window in which select one of the elements. And once the element is selected, then the event or the component has an event that is triggered to notify the selection. Also, we have some, in the user interface palette, we have some components to display the data or to the status of our app, like could be labels, circular progress, even a web viewer. And also we have text boxes so the user can introduce text, or also a specific component, which is a non-visible component. In this case, it's a notifier in order to display alert dialogues or messages to temporarily show a warning or something like that to the user. Okay. Components in our screen will be arranged based on a layout, and for that we use layout components. And App Inventor distinguishes between three types of arrangements in this case: the vertical arrangement, the horizontal arrangement, and the table arrangement. And depending on the layout we use, a layout can contain tiles, so that means that a horizontal arrangement can contain another containers in this case to let's say contain additional components. For instance, here we have the layout, which is the main container that contains a horizontal in this case, container, that contains three containers. One of them is a vertical container. That one is a tabular container, and that one is a vertical. And inside them, then we can place components like buttons, images, and things like that. App Inventor also allows you to work with your mobile sensor sensors. And these sensor components are used in order to read or get data from the internal sensors of your device, such as the accelerometer, your location, your orientation, the temperature. And of course, they depend, the components can be used, or these components can be used only if your mobile or the mobile phone that you're using, this feature is available or not. Because not all sensors, not all mobile devices implement all the sensors. And in particular, there's one which I would like to highlight, which is the clock, which is basically a timer that it's executed or it's used in order to execute things at a periodic time. Like in this case, for instance, you can see here, reading a temperature. And last one, it's the connectivity components in which we use in order to establish the communication between external devices, between your mobile phone and some external device. We use it for Bluetooth communications, and also for, in this case, web communication or serial communication with an Arduino. So we have three main, we have four components, but one of them is based on Bluetooth. It's a client or a server. The client is the in this case your mobile phone connects to an external device, while the server, if you use a server, Bluetooth server, then your mobile phone turns into a server that accepts connection from external devices. Then we have the serial component, in which communicates with serial devices by sending text using a physical USB OTG cable. We use this typically to communicate with an Arduino in this case. And also we have a web component that we can use in order to send HTTP requests like GET, POST, PUT, and DELETE to external web services. So in this presentation, I have introduced how to develop apps with App Inventor. Thank you very much.